Every journey starts with a single footstep. Our lives are one big journey. And journeys are best with friends.
Clint's opening
his... No, promoting the river.
No, we don't.
On the Johnson River in Johnsonland.
Johnsonville.
New Johnsonville.
Yeah.
I'm not telling anyone where places are.
No, that's it. Nice little spot.
Potatoes.
People leaving their rubbish. That's not very good. Not too much. The last spot was terrible. Let's have a look down to the river. So here's a word to young people and anyone that camps. Take your rubbish home. You don't want it there next time, and you don't want to find someone else's rubbish there, and it starts with you. So that's my little note for the day, and river's looking really nice. So we've got the camp set up, got the canoe and the kayak, and I just went into a little shop and bought these little goggles at the last place. We wanted to jump in the water and check out what was in the water, so I'm going to do that right now. Only problem is they're a kid's series, 3 to 6 years, and Clint reckons that's about my mental age, so I should be right with them. It's a bit of an interesting warning on the back. You do not use in shallow water, so I could drown wearing these in the shallow water down here. What's that, Clint?
You'll get shallow water blackout.
Oh no, shallowitis.
Yeah, from hyperventilating before you put your head under.
Yeah. So we'll get the camera and we'll go and see what's in the river. I'm guessing little fish and shrimp and stuff. But it could be a bit of fun. And then we'll go for a fish later.
Alright, I've got them to sort of fit on my head. Let's see if they'll seal. Feels alright. Alright. Let's go exploring the river. This is also my shower for the week. No, I'm kidding. I jump in the water at least 2 or 3 times a day on this trip. Actually, I think half the time we just sit in the water all day long. All right, let's have a look under the water. Did you see anything there? I didn't see anything. Let's go further out. So I've sat down in the water here for a little while now, and as soon as I stop moving around, the fish come around, so that's pretty cool. Let's film some. I think they're actually eating my legs. That's pretty cool. I think we should have a bit of lunch and go for a fish. We got company in camp, have we, Clint?
No.
Look at them all. Hello, Moomoos. Hi.
Hello, Moomoo.
That one looks pretty curious, the tall brown one there. Hey, there he is. It's all happening here, folks. Never a dull moment in camp, whatever this is. We need a name for this camp.
Awesome.
Camp awesome. I got my trusty steed in the water. Got all my gear down there, ready to go. And Clint left about half an hour ago, so I'm going to try and catch up with him. Hopefully he hasn't caught all the fish. And catch some myself. Maybe catch some for dinner.
nice little rapids. Try and pick a good light through here. That's the shallow rock there. Yep, just missed it. And here we go. Oh, oh, gonna touch that one. Yep, touch that one, alright. Oh, I've gone through 3 or 4 sets of rapids now and I haven't found Clint, so I may as well just start having a bit of a fish. I'm sure we'll catch up with him soon. I'm sure we'll find him down the river somewhere. He was just, yeah, he was very keen to go and I was still on the computer transferring files. So, I reckon he's probably, yeah, probably about 500 metres ahead of me at this stage. So I just saw some young rags over on the rocks here. They saw Clint about half an hour ago, so he's way ahead of me. And there's young Clint hanging out.
Oh! I've come back.
Have ya? From where?
Down there.
No, no go or what? I'm
stuck.
Yeah, I'm stuck here.
It gets really gnarly down there. I don't even know if it opens up.
Yeah, okay. Yep, got it. Oh, off there too. Yep, the solo man. How's that for a bit of nice Johnson in Johnsonville whitewater rafting?
You know, the Johnson River at this time of year
is great.
It's just fantastic.
Oh.
Yeah, that was good.
It was, eh?
Yeah.
Yep. Oh, big one. Big one. That could be an eel, the way it's swimming. Either an eel or cod. Not sure. Feels like an eel. Let's have a look. Oh, no. Looks like a cod. Right where you just anchored before.
No way.
Yeah, right under. There he is. Nice little dude.
Little dude.
Yeah, not huge. There's some big rocks here too. Let me just get out. Oh, get out of the zone. Not telling.
On the heavy one.
The quarter ounce petroleum jiggy thingy. Okay, I'm gonna see if I can lip grip this one with the grippers. He's nice and tired. Put that there, I don't lose them. There we go, nice and easy. Actually, change hands there. There we go. That's the one that did it. It's actually a bit of a homemade sort of job. Little spinnerbait blade on yeah, quarter ounce TT jig and a petroleum Z-Man. There we go, let's have a look at him. Oh yeah, he's not a bad fish at all. He's probably just under 50 centimetres, that one. Alright, let's let him go on this side. There we go. Go. Oh, there he goes. Didn't want to release. Beautiful. Not the bass we're after, but we'll keep going. Looks like Clint's walking it down. I think I might shoot these rapids on the side here. Going down. Yep, give it a go. Oh, there's a bit of water in the kayak. Yep, a little bit of water.
Oh,
line.
Yeah, baby.
This is pretty interesting. When I took the water in that last waterfall, I picked up a little mud eye. They are baby dragonfly larvae. So we'll put him back. That's pretty cool. Hey, little dude. I'm going to put you back. There he goes. He's off. You're on. All right, hang on. Coming over. Oh, Clint's just hooked something. I'm almost on the plane here. Woohoo! What do you got?
Big cod.
Big cod? Yeah, that's not bad. Oh, he's nice. Very dark color. That'll be the biggest one so far. Whoa.
He hasn't even fought yet.
Yeah. Tire him out a little bit, otherwise he'll struggle in the net. Yeah, that's a nice one.
Yeah.
Very nice. I think you got him. There you go. Yeah, that's a good one. That's way bigger than the ones. You want the grippers?
Oh, they've got teeth.
Yeah, yeah, they'll shred you. Yeah, that's a nice one he is. Oh, he's going 60. Hold him up for us with both hands. Yeah, nice. Nice fish.
Coolest.
Yeah.
And it is an Eastern?
Yeah, just drop him over the side. Yeah, that's the only thing.
Yeah. See you, dude. Get healthy.
Yeah.
Alright.
He'll bite down. You have to pull it out forward. Down. Yeah, pull it out forward. That's it.
Get healthy, dude.
Beautiful. Fish of the trip so far. Not what we're after, but... Not a bad little prize.
Yeah, but I'm a bit disappointed with his condition.
Yeah, he's a little slabby. Just some spectacular scenery here. This is really nice country. A little bit shallow at times. Okay. But yeah, amazing to paddle through. Or bump through. Oh, that was a touch. Maybe that was a bass. Got it, yes. What is it? Oh, it's got a lot of pull. I have to spin around. I'm gonna put my money on another cod. Let's have a look. Oh, there's two. Look at him. There's a big one and a little one. Actually, that's not a little one. That's not a bad one at all. Nice size one. All right, we'll get this guy in. Oh, yeah, that'll be my biggest for the trip. Once again, not chasing these guys, but there's just nothing coming up other than these. There we go. We got him. Nice comfort lift. Yeah, he's that's almost 60 centimeters, that one. They gotta change the rules on these things. There's so many in the river, and that's all we're catching at the moment. Well, I guess is they're eating the bass. Just hold him for a little while. Although I think he's ready to go. Let go, come on. Let go. They like biting the thing. There he goes. I'll just show you the gear I'm using on this trip. The Samaki Zing 4 to 10 pound spinning rod, and the Ecooda Black Hawk II 2000 reel. Really nice reel, really nice drag on it. And I know a lot of you are going to ask, am I going to change from the cheapy $50 ones to this one? And I reckon I might. It's a nice little reel. This combo just casts really well for some reason. Might be the line too. I've changed to the Samaki Extreme. And yeah, just casts really nicely. Sooner or later, there's got to be a bass hiding in here somewhere. They can't be in the middle of the river, because it's all just shallow and weedy. Oh, that's a big cod. Oh, there's two again. That's not a bad one at all. Still going. There he is. Oh, he's out of that bit of weed. Big fish, that's a nice fish. Oh. Yep, let's see if we can grip this guy. Come on, open your mouth. Got him. That's a healthy looking fish too. Very healthy. Get those hooks out in him straight away. There's one. And... oh, that just fell out. There you go. Let's have a look at you, buddy. Hey. That's getting up around that 65. Centimeters? Eh? Let you go. Come on, kayak. You can do it. Canoe. Oh, it's getting late. I'm getting tired. There we go. Only another 6 kilometers to go. Come on. Got in that time. Third time. And I think, let's see, it's a tiny little cod. Tiny, tiny little cod. Hey. I'll just pull the hooks out of you right there. There we go, and off you go. See a fish.
Well, it's been another long, hard day, and it's just too warm. Daytime temperatures are 38 to 40 degrees, and all the bass are just not feeding. So today, I found a mud mussel. Or a freshwater mussel. You see that guy there? I'm going to smash him open and put out a hook for an eel, hopefully. That's what I'm hoping for. Could catch anything else, really. Hopefully no more Easterns. We don't want an Eastern because we can't eat that. So I'm just going to go and crack this open, put on a little line. Actually, I'll show you the line I found. So I normally have lines that I use for eel fishing, but it's actually illegal to put set lines in trees, so when I find one, I'll cut it off and take it with me. So this here was, just tied to a tree. If you're fishing, you've got to be holding the rod. Set lines are illegal. I'm pretty sure that's everywhere. So I'm just going to tie this to a rod. Just use that bit of line, and water's just over there. And I'll be able to hear the... That's pretty cool, that worked. So instead of the eel I was hoping for, we got this catfish. And the first thing I'm gonna do now is cut these spikes off. They got spike here, and spike here. And while I'm trying to fill it, I don't want those spikes going in me. They've got a bacteria on the fin that really stings for a long time. Now, what I've done with this fish, when I caught him before, I've cut his throat and just bled him to death like that. These guys here, let's see, I'll get a spoon here. They have a really hard top of the head, so you can't brain spike these guys. So, yeah, like you probably hit them with a hammer and they'd be okay. So, yeah, just cut their throat just in front of the heart and they'll bleed out pretty quick. So
for my camp cooking at the moment, I'm going to try and keep it pretty simple. So we only got four ingredients. We got Mr. Catfish, which I'm going to fillet so shortly. We got some curry paste. This one's a red. It's a medium heat. Coconut milk and some beans I bought a couple of days ago that, yeah, they survive all right in my esky with a bit of ice. As I get more into the cooking and traveling and stuff, I'm going to fit out my car and I'm going to show you how it's set up. At the moment it's just an esky with a pop top roof, camper and a canoe, but yeah, the more I have it set up, the more I'll show you later on. Now, I've never done one of these before, so I'm just going to go with fish anatomy, use my trusty sharp knife, and we'll go down on the top of the body. And the bones will generally tell me where I can and can't go. Go through here. And this is actually quite nice. He's sitting up. I think these fins here are holding him upright. So, yeah, interesting way to fillet a fish. I've never done one of these before. I've cooked them on the fire hole, but I've never filleted one. And I've never filleted a fish upright like this. So, actually no, flathead I have done. So this is, yeah, it's working quite well. And I have tasted these with side by side with bass, and to be honest, these actually taste better. They've got more flavour. So, and then I think we go down here. Yeah, that's it doesn't feel like meat there. I'll just go down there. Don't want to cut into the stomach cavity. Go down here, little fly there. And work our way down this way. Yeah, that's the rib cage there. Stay on top of the rib cage. Beautiful. There we go. Now, this meal should be enough for Clint and myself. He's out there trying to catch fish again. But yeah, this with a whole can of coconut cream. As I do more of these videos, I'll get more ingredients and get a little bit fancier, but I'm still going to just do plain, simple food that tastes good. Flavour first. Oh, get away from me, bud. There we go. Turn the heat back on. Not full heat, just a medium sort of heat. And this is, yeah. Oh, there you go. We're having fried bug. Turn that off a little bit more. And it's making a lot of noise there, so hopefully you can still hear me. When you put the paste in, you want it just hot enough so that the aromas come out. You don't want it too hot so it burns or it explodes everywhere, so that should be enough there. That's about a tablespoon and a half. Oh, no, about a tablespoon. It varies for everybody. I like it a little bit mild. I want to taste the fish. So turn that back on, there we go, get it sizzling a bit and then we'll throw the fish in straight away. This is really quick cooking, there we go, move the fish around, don't let it stick on there. And we don't want the fish to cook all the way through, we just want to give it a little bit of colour. And then before it goes too far, we get the coconut milk. Or in this case, yeah, coconut milk in this case. Pop it open. and pour about half of it in, about half. Let that simmer for a little while, turn the heat back up. This will cook very quickly. So I'll let that go for about a minute or so, not too long, because the fish will cook really fast. And we're going to throw our beans in. I don't want the beans to cook too much. I like beans crispy. That leaves the vitamins in them. So the reason for half the tin of coconut cream or milk first is because this cooking here will actually evaporate a lot of the moisture in there. So we'll use half the tin now. Let it cook for a bit, and then just before we eat it, we throw the other tin in. So we'll let that go for another 2 or 3 minutes, just to get those beans a little bit cooked. We still want them crunchy, I like them crunchy. So before I left home, I actually grabbed a couple of kaffir lime leaves. As you can see, I've been on the road about 10 days now, and they're really dehydrated, so they're almost like a dry leaf. If you've got fresh leaves, you just cut them into like really small thin pieces. But because these are dry, I'm just going to crunch them up, nice small pieces, and just throw that right in there. And there's the vein. We'll just throw the vein away. And that just gives it that nice tangy sort of kaffir lime flavour. Alright, that's ready for the other bit of coconut cream. I'll just throw that in there. And this whole meal, it can be bigger, it can be smaller. You can add a few more ingredients, but when it's done with fish, it really shouldn't take more than about 8 to 10 minutes to cook from start to finish. So we'll just get that back up to temperature, and then we'll eat it. So I'm going to try this before Clint gets back. It's I think it's going to be very tasty. Still very hot. And yeah, it only took about 10 or 12 minutes to cook. Nice flavour. Get a bit of fish. Catfish has a really bad reputation in Australia, and I don't think it's warranted. As I was saying to Clint earlier, they go harder than most things, and side by side with like bass and catfish cooked on a fire, catfish has got more flavour. It's very nice. So I'm not going to yell out to him, I'm going to eat a fair bit first. But yeah, there's plenty for both of us here. And definitely let me know if you like these catch and cook videos. Maybe you come up with ideas of recipes or what I should be cooking up. So yeah, just comment, let me know. Any comments, yeah. And in future videos, I'll show you the whole setup when I'm a little bit more set up. So keep watching. I've got probably a few outtakes and fish we didn't catch, or one or the other. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time, next episode.
Oh, another one. I tried fishing the weed edges. It's just too shallow. The river's just too weeded up. Pretty sure we're here at the wrong time of year. We haven't seen a single bass, and we've actually been fishing for quite a while. I'm going to say 6, maybe 7 days on the water, and I'm just trying to make one episode, and yeah, it's just these things. There's definitely no shortage of Eastern Cod here, but this time of year, I'm hoping that the cod haven't eaten all the bass. But this is all we're catching. I haven't actually had one bass strike, and we've fished 3 different rivers now, to be honest. So when it's really hot and the rivers are all weeded up, I don't think it's worth going bass fishing. And they really should make these catch and release. There's so many. And like I said, three different rivers we fished. Every river, we've just caught these. No bass, just these guys. So catch and release, I think, would be the way to go. Make me feel less guilty about catching these things. Because I don't want to catch these, I want to catch some dinner. Do another catch and cook for you. Let this guy go. He's almost tired enough to sort him out. Get the lip grippers again. Oh, there he goes. When I'm holding the leader like that, I'm just holding it really light in case he does take off like that. But to be honest, I'm not sure if they were bass or they were just these guys. He's actually in, yeah, really nice condition. No sore spots on him. Nice belly on him. Hey, off you go. And don't bite down, just let go. Come on. They always bite down. Oh, almost took my finger with him. I reckon I get hurt as much as they do in this sort of scenario where you stick your finger in their mouth.
Now it looks like Clint's got jammed up there. He can't move it with the current. Now he's going to spin around backwards. Actually, I think he's going to walk it.
Oh, a touch. Got him, yes. Oh, that's a big fish. It's not a bad fish. Let's see what we've got. A bit of weight in it. Come on. Come on, what are you? Another Eastern. Well, there's plenty of these guys around. We'll just release him. We'll just release him in the water as well. There he goes. Let's keep going.
I was going to say, my personal observation with going shopping and buying coconut cream and coconut milk, I never buy anything that's light. I always buy the one that's got the most fat content. Because why would you buy something that has the goodness taken out of it? If you're going to buy light stuff, just don't eat it. That's my motto.
Oh, here's an eel. Got an eel. Got him. Oh, he had it. Come on. Oh, you had it! Well, those rocks at the start there where the currents just dug out the rock over millennia. It just looks right. So apparently the gold blades catch a small cod and the silver blades catch the big ones. Look at this. Ooh, come on. Cod about this big. Cod.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, he's sitting here, right here.
Still there?
Yeah, right under the kayak. Alright, have a go at this before we drift away too quick. I'm going to go down and wrap it backwards here. Okay, that's bad news. Alright, that's the way. Go down forwards, not backwards. Come on, canoe. Time to go home. There's Clint. All going home. Long, hard day. Oh, running out of water here.
Thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed that. If you want to watch more videos straight away, click way up there. Otherwise, if you want to see my videos as they're uploaded, click the subscribe button, you get notified straight away. And anyone who wants to help me make bigger and better videos, I've got PayPal and Patreon. So PayPal is really good for
just one-off donations, but you can do monthly as well. And some people may not want to use PayPal. You can do Patreon. So yeah, thanks for watching, and hopefully more to come very soon.